Hello, my friends, and welcome. My name is Dennis, and today I'm gonna film the short review of this motorcycle. As you can see, it's still my Dnepr MT16, and I'll show you what the job guys have done with it so far. Okay, guys, let's start from the front part. As you can see, we have a different tire here, different wheel. Too many spokes compared to the standard, so it's a standard wheel over here, and it's new with the many spokes. I don't remember, actually. I think there are some kind of 90 or 60 spokes on a front wheel. Here we have disc brakes. As far as I remember, it's 260 millimeter discs, and here we have a lever, and here will be installed the hydraulic brakes on both sides. I'll put the callipers from Kawasaki or something, Nissin callipers. And here will be a special tool, the special transit fitting installed. It will be like this or something, and here will be the caliper, and this bearing will go on this axle. Very easy. This axis is different, they have to make the new one over here. Also have the different front light. This light I took from off-road car, Jeep Wrangler. Also, what we have here, the heated grips already installed and fully activated. We don't have electrical system connected to this motorcycle so far, but as I see, it's already connected and in working condition. The K-lock here welded totally, so usually we have a K over here, but now I have the main lock over here. It should be over here. The fuel tank, I don't like it really, guys, because I see a lot of corrosion inside. So there are lots of corrosion, and probably I would have to change this tank, this fuel tank, for the better one, for the better condition, I would say. I just turned on the light for you to actually see how the things are going there. So I don't really like that corrosion. I need to do something with this fuel tank. Down here under this fuel tank we have a different fuel system. You can see some hoses. This is a fuel filter and another one for both carburetors. And here we have electronic fuel valve. So then the turn ignition on, the fuel delivery open, the fuel valve opens, and the fuel goes to the carburetors themselves. By the way, it's hydraulic brakes over here. Maybe I should change this lever for a better one. Also, I forgot to mention that we have sockets here, 12 volts socket for phone charging, etc. And these levers are from the same Kawasaki motorcycle. I changed this as well. This is from Suzuki, and this is from Honda. And this, I don't know what is this. They should connect it with maybe it's start stop or something, or maybe it's a front light. So far I don't know. The clutch cable here goes to the clutch system, and we had to install this new fitting over here for this cable. But this thing is standard over here. The shoulder is standard, and this lever, the clutch lever, is also the standard system. And this cable I took from the parking brake of one of the cars, one of the small cars. And I would say I can push it even with one finger, and it's working much better than standard clutch. It's more soft. I still guess I need to wait for electrical system to be made on this motorcycle. Here I'll probably remove this seat and I'll put this kind of baggage place that I have over here. In this fender I'll put the same over here to put my luggage on, because I don't want to carry someone here. I have the place over here, my sidecar. If you watched my videos before, you probably remember that we changed all the electrical system on this motorcycle and we put it over here on the back side of the sidecar. I have a special place for it. And then rods will go here, part of them, some switches and control switches over here, and some of the rods, some of the wires should go from this house. I'm just gonna show you the aft electronic compartment that we have on a Dnepr motorcycle. As you can see, it's an accumulator battery. We have some sockets as well for charging my video cam during my rides, etc. Electrical system, everything. So this thing will be put it there on the aft part of, on the aft side of my sidecar. Of course, guys, then put this big thing over here in my sidecar. I will lose most of the compartment volume inside, so there will be just place for small baggage, but I still have enough place to put the big bag on the front, for example, and the big bag over here, some kind of rainproof bag, so I can put it here, small bag here, a big bag here, and the big bag over here. So I'll remove the seat, the saddle, and I'll put 1, 2, 3 big bags, and still I'll have enough place to put someone here to ride with someone in the, sitting in the sidecar. So guys, I think it's all for today. Hopefully this winter I'll ride this motorcycle. Thank you for watching and subscribe to my channel. Have a good time.